Today we are going to learn about thousands of free visuals available inside PowerPoint. You go to Insert, Picture, Stock, and then it's not just images. There are so many other things available. Now remember, for this to work, you have to use the Office 365 version of PowerPoint. Desktop versions of PowerPoint do not have this because there are so many pictures and videos that they just can't fit onto your desktop. And that collection is always growing. Picture, stock images, pictures. New is the first category. Always click on new because there may be some things which are related to the current context, which could be important events or festivals. Of course, you can do a keyword search. Search for options, scroll, select the one you want, but there is no hurry to insert it immediately. I want to do another search, select a couple of more pictures. So when I've finished all the selection, I click the insert button once and all the selected pictures get added together. Once you add a picture, you can arrange them, select them and say picture tools layout, and it'll create a smart art. You can also change transparency or use artistic effects and then use them the way you want. The next thing you should know is videos. By the way, you must have seen that if you type something and click on the designer button, those pictures and videos are coming from this collection. Now you have direct access to it as well. Lot of videos, and these are special videos. They are short, so these are loopable videos inserted in such a way that when you run the slide, it runs automatically. Usually they are used as background, but you can also use them for illustration. Remember, you can also do crop as well as colors in videos. The next thing you should know about is icons. They are graphics. They are not just any kind of graphic. They are SVG graphics. What does that mean? If you resize them, they are going to remain crisp. If it was a picture and if you resize it too big, it's going to get blurred. But sometimes you want to change their color. Yes, you can change the graphic color, but that's one color. You can click on the icon, ungroup, and then ungroup again, so that individual shapes are now available, which you can use to recolor. The next one element there is stickers. Treat them as images so you can crop them, recolor them, artistic effects and so on. But generally they are just used to lighten a formal presentation. Then there is a separate category called illustrations. There are lots of categories. Choose the ones you want, insert it into your presentation. Now you may say that yellow color is not what I want. Agreed, that's called the accent color. When you insert it into your presentation, it will look at the palette or the theme of your presentation, find the accent color, and that yellow will change to the relevant color. Of course, because these are SVG, you can ungroup them and separately color them as well. Next thing is cutout people, and you will see the first page showing different people, but as you go along, each person is separately represented. And the best part about this is, you choose any one of them, insert it, the background is transparent. So these people can easily be added to existing slides or scenes. Finally, we have cartoon people. There are components of cartoons. There are body parts, there are faces and expressions, and you assemble them together to create a cartoon of your own. And the best part is these are also SVG, so you can ungroup them and color them separately. What is not there in this dialog but is available is insert 3D objects. Now, when you add a 3D object, 3D objects also have a special kind of animation available. They have arrive, that is how does it come in, and then different kinds of turntable, swing, jump and turn while they are on the screen, and then leave or something like disappear. So let me give you an example. I've inserted the 3D object called microphone, and my last slide is Q&A. So I want to show that while I was talking, the microphone was pointed at me, means away from the audience. And the Q&A slide comes, the microphone rotates, and it's now pointing towards the audience. How do I do that? Well, I first rotate it towards me or away from the screen, duplicate the slide, then again rotate it towards the audience, and then in the second slide, I just apply a transition called morph. And now when you run it, it has a beautiful impact. Creating a great presentation is one part of the story. How do you deliver it in a great way? That's also important. So watch this video, which tells you 5 things you can do to present better. That's it for now. See you next time. Take care.